best. You can be the King Kong banging on your chest. You can beat the world, you can beat the war. You can talk to God, go banging on his door. You can throw your hands up, you can beat the clock. You can move a mountain, you can break rocks. You can be a master, don't wait for luck. Dedicate yourself and you go find yourself. You can run the mile, you can walk straight through hell with a smile.
You can be the hero, you can get the gold. Breaking all the records they thought never could be broke.
Yeah, do it for your people, do it for your pride. You're never gonna know if you never even try.
Do it for your country, do it for your name. Cause there's gonna be a day when you're
standing in the hall of fame. And the world's gonna know your name.
Politicians be preachers, yeah, yeah. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions. Be truth seekers. Be students, be teachers. Be politicians, be preachers, preachers, yeah. Be believers, be leaders. Be astronauts, be champions.
Standing in the hall of fame,
yeah.
And the world's gonna know your name,
yeah.
Earl is a 1955 graduate of Dodgeman High School. He was a letter winner in football, basketball, and baseball. He was homecoming co-king and honorary football captain. He was co-founder of the Dodgeville Slow Pitch League in 1969 and served as commissioner for 10 years. He was one of the great people who volunteered their time to coach kids in the city softball leagues of the Herb Harris era. He provided officials to DHS for JV and freshman football for over 20 years. He has been commissioner of the Dodgeville City Basketball League for the last 35 years and remains in that position today. He has been a WIAA official since 1969, working games in football, basketball, baseball, and softball. As of August of this year, he had officiated, listen to this, 7,389 games. I figured it out. If it's 2 hours a game, that's almost 2 years of your life. Approximately 85% of those games were in Dodgeville. He was a 2005 recipient of the Golden Whistle Award from the Wisconsin Basketball Coaches Association. I had the good fortune of being Earl's basketball officiating partner for 20 years. Not once in the hundreds of games scheduled did Earl cancel, even when he didn't feel well. We endured snowy roads, smelly locker rooms, and even at times, believe it or not, unreasonable coaching. I wish, none are here today. I wish we had a quarter for each time we heard the phrase, call them both ways. But I must say that even we laughed one night, a very loud fan from Earl during a quiet moment, all against, don't quit your Jay Z job, boys. Earl is an amazing man. loves sports and the people who play them. He knows the rule book like the back of his hand. He always takes the verbal criticism that all refs must take with good humor and as a gentleman. He is extremely devoted to his family. Earl Williams being at Dodgeville High School, making sure the games are played correctly and fairly, is a legacy. It is extremely fitting that this plaque honoring him into the Hall of Fame will be there permanently. Congratulations, Earl.
After that, wasn't nice. I would be more comfortable on a football field in front of 5,000 people than I am standing here. But I would like to thank the committees for voting me in, and I would like to congratulate all those others that are going in tonight, including Coach Denny Murphy. Coach Murphy coached Darlington Holiday. He'll be coaching at first base. He would kind of inch his way up to the 3-foot running line. I just feel the catcher signals. I would think Coach Denny at bat. He would think, oh, I thought that was the hitter.
Yeah.
I started football in 1969 at the JV level. We moved to varsity in 1974. One of those games in 74 was Nora Grove at Monroe, coached by Dick Mundell. And I've done a number of games for Dick over the years. Dick was always, he had a little something. After two or three flags, he had a saying, too much officiating. I want to thank my family for the support over the years. My wife Betty for several thousand nights home alone. And son Kevin, who turned in the paperwork for this thing, turned in these badges we got, provided me with a ride last night. I will continue to officiate as long as the knees, the body, holds up. Including on this coming January 29th, Dodgeville Girls versus Ivor Grant JV game, there will be a three-man officiating group. That probably don't happen very often for girls to be. It will be myself, son Kevin, and my grandson, Henry Figures.